Hello everybody, 2015 CorvetC7 here, and today we're going to be playing some more Minecraft. Now this is a different type of video than what I usually do, but I have been playing Minecraft since 2014, and I've been playing for a while, so I've picked up a lot of tips and tricks and just stuff along the way that I would like to share with you guys. So this is the Create New World menu. Here we're just going to call it Tutorial. Or whatever. It's gonna be survival, default. I like to have the bonus chest on just because it gives you a little bit of stuff just to start with, but I'm gonna leave it off so that I can, show you. So, a lot of this depends on where you spawn. If you spawn in a good location, you can live inside of a mushroom, or you can dig a house underground, which is what I do a lot. Okay, I've spawned in a good location. Oh, I spawned in a great location. It's a ravine right here. Oh, gee. Okay, that's. I would advise against jumping into the ravine instantly when you spawn here. Here's the seed. I'll put that in the description. Oh my gosh. Okay, let me get out of here. I will be right back. There we go. Okay. So, again, there's the seed, which will be in the description of the video. So, you'll spawn, if you use this seed, you'll spawn here. And, wow, there's some good wood around. So, the first thing you want to do is you want to run. No, not run. But you kind of do, because you want to get some wood. Any wood is fine, but this is probably, what your intuition has told you to do already. So we're gonna grab some wood. And this is done right. No. There's nothing you can really get wrong about grabbing wood. Because it's like the most easiest thing to do in the game. That's not English, but sorry. So you just take your wood. So I got six planks. So that means. See, this already puts walls around you and a roof over your head. So what you're gonna do is break the stalk in the middle of the mushroom. If you spawn near a mushroom, or if you don't, dig a little hole in the ground. I'll show you how to do that later. But for right now, see, let's yeah, craft. We got 24 from that. First thing I'm gonna craft is one of these bad boys, the crafting table. Then with the rest, I'm just gonna put walls down so that the mobs can't come in here and get me at night. Okay, so just gonna grab some more wood, and now I can put stuff here, there. And most importantly, here. And now you have a little place to be for tonight. Now, one thing that I would highly recommend doing is at this point, make sure you have wood. So yeah, we still have a lot of time in the day. The sun's moving up still. Okay, that is your skeleton. Okay, no. And they'll thank me later. This is gonna allow you to skip your first night. Now, one of the things. When you start a survival is just finding out how to survive the first night. But that is really easy if you do it the way I'm doing it. So if we just craft all that into oak because we don't need it for anything else. I'm hearing a skeleton, but I don't know where it is, so I'm just not going to worry about it. You can see we've spawned in a plains biome, which has mushrooms near it and a lot of sheep, which is good. I spawned in a really good location, honestly, and I seriously did not plan this seed, like, at all. I just generated a completely random world to spawn here. So you're gonna want to make some sticks, like that, and then put them, arrange them like this, and you're gonna want to make a wood pick. You will get an achievement for that, or you should. But what I want to do is find a cave or. I don't think a ravine is going to be the best choice at this point, but good thing that there's a cave right over here to drop down into. Collect a bit of coal. Oh, great. That's what a skeleton is. Hopefully I don't die. That'd suck. Die. Oh good, Skeleton, no, he's still alive. Oh geez. Yes, get down there. Okay. So you're just gonna need a little bit of coal. And then... yeah, so 2 should be enough. Then 11 cobblestone. And you'll see why you need 11 in a minute. Make your way back to the surface. For me, that's easy. I just gotta do this. Run back to your little mushroom hut that you made earlier. Okay, it should be about noon now. You're gonna wanna come in here, go to your crafting table, make, first thing you wanna make is a furnace, and then then you're gonna place your furnace right there. Second thing you're gonna wanna make with these two leftover sticks and this 3 stone is a stone pickaxe. And we are gonna need food, fairly soon. Yeah, like now, cause I can't sprint. Alright, let's worry about food now, actually, because that is a good part of the tutorial. So, unfortunately, I'm going to have to kill one of these sheepies. But you shouldn't have to do this if you find a pig around, just kill that. Yeah, sorry, sheep. I just had to kill you for your mutton. Before we put that in the furnace, though, I'm going to want to go grab some iron, and seeing as I'm slow, I will... be right back. So you come back, you put one piece of coal in the furnace. One piece of coal will smelt 8 items. Unfortunately, we only have 4. So some of this is gonna go to waste. But it doesn't matter, really, in the early stages, because right now we're just trying to survive the first night. So as soon as that second one smelts up, I will shove the mutton in there. Okay, wait for it. Okay, so now we can take these 2 iron ingots and we can make shears. So now what you're gonna wanna do is find one of these unkilled sheep and shear him. So now you have 3 wool, and he will regrow that eventually. You have 3 wool, which is enough to make yourself a basic, well, not basic, they're all the same, but white bed. Bam, now this will allow you to skip the night. So now when it turns to night, you can right-click that, and you will go to sleep. Now, to keep the monsters from walking in on you in your sleep, all you gotta do is craft 1 set of oak doors. That does take a fair bit of wood. Then you can place one right there, and you don't need to worry about the mobs coming in to get you. So, now you essentially have the freedom to roam about your world and... do whatever you want the rest of this day without having to worry about mobs, as soon as it gets dark. And then, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab a bit more wood, and I'm going to make a chest, which I can use to store items in for the time being. Now whenever you die, you'll respawn right in your house. Where's my food? Oh, here it is. Okay. Oh, man. Alright, that is your first night survived. Now, on the second day, you want to spend the second day essentially just kind of upgrading your tools a little bit. Again, looking for spiders, and you'll see why by the end of the video. Okay, so... yes, we do want coal, but we also want more of this stuff, this stone. The reason we want more of that is because we want to upgrade our tools to stone tools, but if you do have access to iron, get that instead, because it is really good. the tools that you can make out of iron are just like lower durability versions of the diamond tools for the most part. And so, oh my gosh. Okay, yeah, those sounds will play every once in a while. Don't worry, they don't mean anything. They're just there to freak you out. And they will seem to be coming from caves. They are pretty freaky, but that's like probably the scariest element of Minecraft right there, is that little sound. Yeah, that is really freaky. Okay. Oh man, I'll look past it. Anyway. For the second night, if you do really want to go out hunting, you're probably gonna want a stone sword. A lot better than the wooden one. So yeah, I only have one piece of string, so I will show you what to do with the string and then end off the episode, and see you guys again in the next one.
Tear from your eye, I'll take you back, I'll take you back, I'll take you back, boy. Lay down your pride, wipe the tear from your eye, I'll take you back, I'll take you back, I'll take you back, but if you don't like girls that are stronger than you, and if you don't like girls that are faster than you, and if you don't like girls that are smarter than you, well then you might not like me, you might not like me.
All the achievements I've been getting. So anyway, you want to run down to the nearest water source, which in my world is right here, and you want to grab one bucket of water. Come back up here. Just dig a 1x3 hole. The reason it's 1x3 is because if you could fill 1x3 with water, but it doesn't have streams, then you have an infinite water source right there, and you can start farming. And you don't have to run all the way down to the river every time you want to just grab a bucket of water. You know, go 4 blocks on each side, because that's how much the water can reach. Managed to break some grass if it's in the way, but that's alright, it gives you seeds. Alright, so now that you've now that you have that there, you can plant your seeds in it. And the reason I'd be telling you to do it this way is because this will be growing while you're running around, adventuring, killing mobs, mining. This will be here growing. So you will be getting food without actually having to do anything. That is, if the animals don't trample up your crops, but they shouldn't if they're just walking across them, so. That is where I'm gonna have to leave this episode off, guys. If you enjoyed it, please leave a like. And subscribe for more of this tutorial series. I will be doing more of it, starting tomorrow. And I'll see you guys all in the next one. Bye.